Thursday. I am Dr. Megan Clunk. I'm a physical therapist and Pilates instructor. Thanks for joining me today. We're going to do a 45-minute mat workout without a prop today. So if you have a pillow or a 9-inch ball, feel free to use that. But it's not necessary. So if you have any lower back tenderness, any neck issues, sometimes it's nice to have a pillow or a ball or a small towel roll. But we're gonna get started, okay? Okay, so you're going to start in a staggered position so that your left foot is slightly ahead of your right. And I want you to begin bending your knees, sending your hips back, reaching your arms forward, and then press out to straighten. So you're going to hinge like you're sitting in a chair, press through the front heel to straighten and lift tall. Inhale as you reach forward, and exhale, press back. I'm going to turn to the side so you can kind of see what I'm doing here. You're sending the hips back, reaching the arms forward, and pressing up tall. Good, a couple more times here like this. So make sure your stance isn't too narrow here. You want to have your feet about hip distance apart. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, press back. Two more times. Drawing the navel back towards the spine. And last time. Good, now keep your arms back and you're still going to hinge forward at the hips and press nice and tall. So the elbows are extended nice and straight, squeezing through the triceps, and collarbones are open wide. Just a couple more times like this. And now I want you to stay in that hinged position. You're going to round the spine, reach the arms forward, extend the spine as the arms reach back. So you're rounding and extending. Good, most of the weight should be in that front heel. Exhale, draw back, tuck the tail under, and extend. Good, I'm gonna face you again. So you know what I'm doing now. Two more times. Good, now I want you to try and tap your fingers to the ground and press up straight. So all that weight is in your front heel. Really engaging through the glutes here. And tap down. And extend. Tap. Keep the collarbones open wide. Not collapsing through the front of the chest. Gonna do two more times here. And last time. Good. Now stay in that hinged position or return to it. Your palms are facing the sky as you press the elbows or the hands back behind you. Inhale and then exhale, reach. Inhale, exhale, reach. Good, make sure you're not rounding the shoulders forward. Extending two opposite directions through the crown of the head and through the tail. Good, one last thing. I want you to float that back leg up. You're coming into a T position and then return back to your semi-lunge. So you're lifting that back leg up, coming into a T, and then lower down. I'll turn to the side again. So lifting up, one straight line, head to toe, challenging the balance. Now if your balance is too shaky, you can hold onto a wall or keep the toes down. Last time. Lift up. Good. And now widen your stance here. Rotate your toes and your knees out to the sides and just bend your knees and straighten just a few times through center. Relaxing through the hips and through the arms. Good. Couple more times here, and now we'll switch sides. Okay, so now your right much weight through that back foot. Towards the spine. Inhale, extend. Try to stay long through the back of the neck once you understand the movement. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, one more time. Exhale. Inhale, upright your spine. Now try to tap the ground and press up. So your arms or your hands are straddling your front foot. One hand on either side. Again, trying not to collapse through the chest. Staying open. Behind you. Now your palms are facing the sky as you press the hands behind you. Inhale to fold, exhale to press. Should really feel that right glute heating up here, hamstring. Three more times. And two. And one. Good. And return. To that straddle position, feet turned out, and now reach the arms forward, round the spine, and extend as you reach the arms back. Good. Just a couple more times here before we hit the mat. Oh, I forgot something. I forgot the balance part. So, sorry. Come back to your lunge position, arms are reaching back behind you. You're going to lift that back foot off. A T position and then lower down. So those arms are staying straight behind you as you lift off and lower back down. Three more times lifting. Find your teeth and return. And one more time lifting off. Nice job. And return. Sorry to fake you out there. Okay, so make your way down to the mat. Your hands are under your shoulders, knees are under your hips. And I want you to just begin reaching your right arm out overhead and then return. And then left arm reaches and return. Good. Try not to shift the weight too much. Keep your weight even in both knees. Sorry, I thought something happened. This is hot out. I'm afraid of my phone overheating. I have it in the shade, but we'll see. Good. One more time each way. And now keep your right arm extended. You're going to pull your elbow wide and then in towards your body and reach it overhead. And exhale. Inhale, reach. stay with your right knee lifted. You're opening your left arm out to the side and then close it back in, and now switch sides. Right arm opens, left foot lifts and lower and open. Close it back in. Close it in. One more time each way. And now lower yourself the whole way down. Arms continue overhead. And then slowly roll back up, pushing the feet heavy. Find a tall spine. Now I want you to connect your feet and open your knees into like a semi-diamond position. Roll yourself back. And have your arms kind of wide. I just want you to close your knees together, squeeze the knees, and open them out. And exhale, squeeze, and open, exhale, and inhale. Two more times like this. Make sure you're initiating the movement still with your core. This time as you squeeze the knees together, you're going to rotate to your right. Don't let the knees shift, and then allow them to open through center. And now squeeze the knees together as you rotate left. And open through center. Exhale. Inhale, open. Exhale. And inhale, open. One more time each way. And squeeze. And open. Keep the knees open. You're going to float the feet towards you and tap them down. Exhale, pull in deeper with your core. Tap down two more times. And last time, try not to collapse through the chest. Keep your heart bright. Good. Keep the knees open. Continue the rest of the way down. Whew. One, two, and now roll back up, keeping the knees open. It's a little harder this way. You can use your hands on your thighs if you need to. And then open into a butterfly position. Give yourself a little rest. Close the legs together, roll yourself the whole way back onto the mat, arms down by your sides, and I want your feet hip distance apart. Arms are going to come above the chest now, and open into a goalpost or a cactus position here. So you're going to press into your heels and roll the hips up into a bridge position with control. Inhale here at the top. And exhale, slowly lower back down, piece by piece. And exhale, rolling back up, drawing in through the center. Try to align the body through the center. Did a lot of rotation there and twists. Just resetting the spine. Imagine it's running along train tracks here. Rolling back up. And rolling back down. And exhale, back up. Stay up at the top. And now you're going to close the elbows together and open out wide. So the hips are staying lifted. Your weight is settled in between your shoulder blades here. Exhale to close, inhale to open, exhale to close, inhale to open, two more times, and last time. Good, now keep the arms open into goalpost. You're just going to drop your right hip towards the mat and then level out. So your knees are staying still, they're staying even. You're just twisting through your center, through the pelvis slightly here, and level out. So it's happening deep within your lower abdominals, through your pelvic floor and your glutes. Little rotation. rotations here. So your left hip drops a little bit and then levels out. And right hip. Good. One more time each way. And now stay here at the top. Reach your arms overhead. Really lift your shoulders up towards your ears and roll your hips down, reaching your tailbone away from your fingertips. You should feel a nice stretch along the sides of your body. And now hinge your hips back up. You're going to circle your arms underneath of you. And then hinge at the hips to lower as the arms reach overhead. And circle around. And arms come underneath as the hips lift. Hinge at the hips as the arms go overhead. Just a few more times here. And lower down. And pressing up. And lower back down. Very nice. Now, you're going to take your right hand and press it against the front of your left thigh. And your right leg is going to reach straight up to the ceiling. Left arm is also reaching straight, straight up to the ceiling. So your hand is pressing into the thigh, thigh is pressing into the hand. Arm and leg reach away from each other. Inhale, arm and leg reach away from each other. And exhale, pull them back in. So try not to go too far so that you're rotating. Your shoulders and your hips stay still and square to the ceiling. This is a nice way to work the core without lifting the head and shoulders. And two more times. Last time. Good. Now I want your arm and leg to reach away from each other. And then you're going to pull your knee in as you reach the left arm down by your hip. So inhale, open. Exhale, close. You shouldn't feel this going into your back. If you do, lift your leg up higher, away from the ground. Inhale. And exhale. Two more times. And last time. Nice job. So now I want you to plant your left foot down into the mat. And right leg is extended up towards the ceiling. Your left hand's gonna go behind your head. You're going to rotate your left shoulder towards your right knee and lower down, and then lift both hips equally off the mat and tap down. So exhale, rotate, inhale, lower. Exhale, press the hips evenly from the mat and lower. Exhale. And inhale, exhale, press, and lower. One more time each way. Now keep the hips lifted. You're going to lower that leg down away from you, and then flex to lift. Point to lower, flex to lift. Three more times. Two. And one. Turn your arms by your sides and slowly control yourself back down onto the mat. Nice job. So bring your legs into tabletop. We're going to do the other side. Your right hand is going to press against the front of your left thigh. Right leg, left arm are reaching to the ceiling. Inhale, open away. And exhale, close it back in. So they're opening out to the sides of the room. And exhale, close it in. And inhale. Exhale, close it in. Inhale, open. Good. Two more times.
the legs stay thick, straight, you're drawing back through your center. Both legs are staying lifted. Good. Switch and hold. Switch and hold. Switch and hold. Squeeze the legs together. Lower them down.
And now prop up onto your bottom elbow. You're going to reach your arms overhead. Legs are going to float. Roll onto your back, draw your knees in. Extend the legs out straight. Try to keep them lifted as you roll back onto your side. And roll yourself back, draw the knees in. So you're kind of massaging out that glute a little bit that you just worked up. See, I can be nice. One more time. And now stay onto your back with your legs lifted in tabletop. Make sure you're not hanging out here in your shoulders. Stay bright and lifted. Inhale the knees over to the right. Exhale center. Inhale, rotate left. Exhale center.
Circle them over the legs, roll through the spine,
circle the arms back behind you,
up and around, pull over the legs, around through the spine,
two more times,
circle around, dive forward, pulling up through the spine,
last time,
dive forward,
and roll up through the spine nice and tall. Great. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions at all, please send me a message. You can comment on this video. And I'm planning to have another class at 9 o'clock live on Sunday and 11 o'clock live on Saturday. So, trying to think of anything else. I offer private one-on-one sessions virtually for physical therapy and Pilates. So if that interests you, you can also send me a message about that. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoy the class